Hi, in this video I am going to explain how to prepare trial balance. So before that we need to have some basic knowledge about accounts. So accounts is the art of recording all the transactions in the books of accounts is called accounts. Okay, so in accounts the first thing is journal. So journal is a book where we use to record all the transactions in a systematic manner. In a proper way we need to record all the transactions. For that purpose we need to have journal. Okay, journal is only for recording all the transactions. And after recording all the transactions into the journal, the second step is we need to group the similar kind of transaction. For that purpose we need to have ledger. After preparing the ledger, the third step will be trial balance. Trial balance is not an account. It's only a statement which shows debit balances and credit balances of all accounts in the ledger. Okay, this will be like this. Just list out all the items which you have prepared in the ledger. And with this information, they ask you to prepare trial balance. So in order to prepare trial balance, you need to understand two things. First one is debit and credit. So you need to have thorough knowledge about debit and credit. So only thing you are going to do that, just write each and every item in particular column and enter the amount either debit side or credit side. So in order to identify whether the particular item is belong to debit or credit, you need to have thorough knowledge of golden rules. You know the three golden rules, no? So you need to have thorough knowledge about real account, nominal account and personal account. First thing, you need to identify whether the particular item is belong to real account or nominal account or personal account. Then you can easily identify whether the particular item is debit side or credit side. So first you need to identify the item belong to real account or nominal account or personal account. Based on that, with the help of this knowledge, you can able to enter this amount either debit or credit according to golden rule. Let me explain the golden rule first, then we can easily prepare the trial balance in an effective manner. These are the three account, that is golden rules. First one, real account. Real account rule is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. The best example for real account is cash. When you purchase any item, cash goes out, the particular item comes in. When you sell something, what goes out? Goods goes out and cash comes in. So for real account, cash will be the best example. Apart from cash, all assets, whether it is a current asset or fixed asset, all assets are belong to real account. Cash and all assets are belong to real account. And second one is personal account. Personal account means any person, whether it is a natural person or artificial person, is a personal account. So personal account means any person. The first thing is business is separate entity, owner is separate entity. So while you enter all the transaction, you need to consider, you need to view all the transaction from business point of view. Okay, so in that way you can able to identify whether the particular item is debit side or credit side. The rule is, for personal account rule is debit the receiver, credit the giver. For example, X invested his amount into his own business. So what is the journal entry? Cash account data to capital account, that is X capital account. So X is the owner. He is a real owner of the company. He contribute his own amount into his own business, but that amount, the X capital, should be recorded in credit side. Why? Because he is a giver. He or she will be the giver. He contribute his amount into his own business, no? So capital should be recorded in credit side. In the same way, the X, the owner, withdraw some amount from business. It's called drawings. So drawing means the proprietor withdraw some amount in the form of cash or in the form of goods, withdraw amount of goods from the business. So that transaction is called as drawings. So the drawing should be recorded in debit side. Why? Because X withdraw amount from the business. So he or she will be the receiver. So drawing should be entered in debit side, capital should be entered in credit side. Why? Because capital is the amount which is contributed by proprietor. He is a giver. So credit. Drawing is the amount which is drawn from the business. So he or she should be recorded in debit side. Third one is nominal account. So nominal account just like a profit and loss account, where we used to record all the expenses and losses and incomes and gains. So nominal account rule is debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. You need to identify the particular item is expense or income. If it is expense, means just debit the item. If it is income, means just credit the item. That's all. So in this way you can able to prepare trial balance. So first thing, you need to identify the particular item, the particular transaction is belong to real account or personal account or nominal account. Then you can enter either debit side or credit side according to this rule. If it is expense, means debit. If it is an income, means credit. If the person is received the benefit, means debit. If the person giving some amount, some goods to the company, means credit. If the particular cash or asset comes in, means debit. Sales goes out, no, so just credit. So based on the debit and credit rule, you can able to record the amount on either debit side or credit side according to the rule. So I've given some example. Let us see the example, then we can go for problem. For real account, all assets are belong to real account, whether it is a current asset or fixed asset. All assets are related to or belong to real account. Buildings is an asset, machinery is an asset, furniture is an asset, and second example is goods. So when you purchase goods, goods comes in. When you sell something, goods goes out. So purchase as well as sales also belong to real account. So when you purchase any item, what will happen? Goods comes in. So what is the real account rule? Debit what comes in. So purchase should be recorded in debit side. So what is the rule of real account? Debit what comes in. When you purchase something, purchase goods comes in. So purchase always debit. Why? Because when you purchase, goods comes in. Sales always credit. Why? Because when you sell something, goods goes out. So real account rule is what comes in, purchase comes in, what goes out, sales goes out. In the same way, for purchase return and sales return, just opposite. So when you receive some item, okay, from customer, if the customer find any defective item in the sales, they have the right to return the goods. It's called sales return. Sales is credit, no, sales return will be debit. Why? Because the customer returning the goods, no. So when they return some item, what will happen? The company receive item from the customer. So sales return is always debit. Sales credit because goes out, sales return debit. Why? Because comes in. In the same way, purchase debit. Why? Because when you purchase any item, goods comes in. Real account rule is debit what comes in. So purchase comes in, no, debit side. When you find any defective item in the purchased item, you have the right to return the item to your supplier. So when you return some item, is called purchase return. So when you return some item, it will be goes out. So purchase debit because it comes in. Purchase return will be credited. Why? Because it goes out. So purchase debit, sales credit. Purchase return credit, sales return debit. So this item also belong to real account. And the next one is cash. So cash in hand is an asset, no, cash at bank also is an asset. So cash comes in, cash goes out. So cash is one of the important thing which always comes in and goes out according to the transaction. So all these three items are belong to real account. With this knowledge, you can able to identify the particular item is belong to real account or not. Based on the golden rule, you can able to write whether it is a debit side or credit side. The second example is personal account. So what is the personal account rule? Debit the receiver, credit the giver. So when the person receives any benefit, or when the person gives some benefits, so you can easily debit the person or credit the person according to the transaction. So personal account rule is debit the receiver, credit the giver. So first item is capital. So capital is the amount which is invested by the proprietor. So owner's capital. For example, X contributed 1 lakh rupee into the business. So what is the entry? Journal entry. Cash account debtor to X capital. Why? Because X is a person. He is a owner. He contribute his own amount into the business. In this case, he is a receiver or giver. He gives some amount into the business. Okay, so he will be the giver. So what is the personal account rule? Debit the receiver, credit the giver. He giving, he contribute his amount into the business. No, so capital should be credited. Why? Because credit the giver. And second one, drawings. Drawings means proprietor, which he invested some amount into the business, no, from that capital he withdraws some amount for his personal use, not for official use. He withdraws some amount for his own or private use. That amount is called as drawing. Drawings can be in the form of cash or in the form of goods, whatever may be the case. If it is for personal use, means that should be debited. Why? Because he receives benefit from the company. So drawing should be debited. Capital should be credited. Why? Because he is giving some amount into the business. Drawing should be debited. Why? Because the proprietor withdraws some amount or receives some amount from the business. So drawing should be debited. And third one is debtors and creditors. Debtor is a person, one who receives benefits from the company without paying any money. In future, he or she is going to make payment. So till that time, he or she is called debtor. A group of debtor combinedly called as sundry debtors. Okay, so debtor is a person, one who receives benefit from the company. Okay, so credit, all credit sales go to debtors. Okay, so debtor will be debited. Why? Because debit the receiver, debtor receiving benefit from the company. So debtor should be debited. And creditor is a person, one who gives benefit to the company without receiving any cash. So creditor means supplier. We used to purchase item from the supplier on credit basis. All the suppliers called as creditor. Okay, they are giver. They are giving some item, some goods to the company. So they are giver. So what is the rule of personal account? Debit the receiver. Debtors should be debited. Credit the giver. Creditors are giving the benefit to the company. No, supplier. So all the suppliers are creditors. So they should be credited. All the customers or debtors, all the debtors should be debited. So with the help of these knowledge, you can able to identify the personal account, and you can able to identify whether the item is belong to debit or credit according to the personal account rule. Next one is nominal account. So nominal account is very, very simple. In the business organization, you can find a lot of expenses and income. So all the expenses, whether it is a direct expense or indirect expense, all the expenses are debited. Okay, all the incomes and gains should be credited. So very simple. So nominal account is just like a profit and loss account, where we used to record all the expenses and losses under debit side and all incomes and gains under credit side. So nominal account rule is debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. For example, in organization we need to make payment as salary. So salaries, rent and all expenses should be debited. Okay, all incomes and gains, that is rent received, discount received, so all these things are called as incomes. So all expenses should be debited, all incomes and gains should be credited. So this is the rule of nominal account. So with this knowledge, now you can prepare trial balance in an effective way. Let us see the problem. The following balances are extracted from the books of Miss Alice Magnolia. Prepare trial balance as on 30th June 2014. So the summarized, the statement is given. So I told you, no, trial balance is not an account. It is a statement which shows debit balance and credit balance of all accounts in the ledger. So we have prepared the ledger. No, from the ledger, we have taken all the accounts. This is a statement where we used to list out all the accounts. So now with the help of this, they ask you to prepare trial balance. In order to prepare trial balance, you need to understand two things: whether the particular item is belong to debit or credit. That's all. For that, you need to have thorough knowledge of golden rules. With that knowledge, you can able to identify each and every item. Then you can enter the amount either debit or credit according to the rule. First item, see, capital 470,200. So capital is the amount which is contributed by Alice Magnolia. So Alice Magnolia's capital is a debit side or credit side? Just refer the golden rule. She is a giver. Okay, so what is the rule of personal account? Personal account rule is debit the receiver, credit the giver. So Magnolia giving or Magnolia contribute his her own amount into her own business. So this should be recorded in credit side. Capital always credit side. Just record this item in trial balance. Then second item, just see the second one, machinery 158,000. So machinery is an asset. I told you, know, all asset, whether it's a current asset or fixed asset, cash, all accounts are belong to real account. So what is a real account rule? Debit what comes in. So when you purchase machinery, what comes in? Machinery comes in, cash goes out. So machinery is always debit. Why? Because it is an asset. So just write this item under debit side of trial balance. Second item, machinery 1,58,000. So we have entered this amount under debit side. Then third one, cash in hand. So cash also, it's a real account. It is an asset, no? So asset means all assets are debit balance. So cash in hand 6,000 rupees, also real account. Enter this amount under debit side. Then next one, sundry debtors. Sundry debtor means the group of customers, the group of debtors combinedly called as sundry debtors. So debtor is a person, one who receives benefit from the company without paying any money. So all credit sales are converted into debtors. Okay, they have received item from the business, but they didn't pay any amount. In future they are going to pay. So till such time, this will be considered as an asset. So all assets are debit balance, no? So sundry debtor, so debtor is a personal account. Personal account rule is debit the receiver. Just enter this amount under debit side. Why? Because they have received benefit from the company. Sundry debtors, how much? 48,000. Then next one, buildings. Building is an asset, no? So all assets are belong to real account. Real account rule is debit what comes in. So when you purchase any asset, asset comes in. So debit this item in trial balance. Buildings 3,20,000. Next one, repairs. Repairs is not an asset. So repair is a expense in the organization. So any expense, all expenses and incomes belong to nominal account. What is the rule of nominal account? Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So repair is an expense for the organization. This should be debited. Why? Because it is an expense. So just write repairs. Repairs, how much? 5,300 debit side. Next item, stock on commencement. So stock also real account. I told you, no, goods. okay, in the form of raw material, a work in progress or finished goods. In any form, all the stocks are real account. So stock on commencement means opening stock. So stock should be debited. It's a real account, no? What comes, real account rule is debit what comes in. So this is the last year closing stock will be the opening stock for current year. Current year closing stock will be the opening stock for next year. So stock on commencement will be debited in trial balance. Opening stock. How much? 33,000. Next item. Insurance premium. So insurance premium is an expense. Okay, so the organization need to take insurance policy. For that they need to make some payments periodically. Insurance premium is an expense. So all expenses are nominal account. Nominal account rule is debit all expenses. It is an expense, no? Just debit this item. Insurance premium. Much 3,300 debited. Now next item, sundry creditors. Just now explained, you know, debtor is a person, one who receives benefit from the company. Okay, that should be debited. Sundry creditor means creditor is a person, one who gives benefit to the company without receiving any cash. In future, they are going to collect amount from the business. So sundry creditor means the group of supplier called as sundry creditor. So creditor is a person, one who gives benefit. So it should be recorded in credit side. What is the personal account rule? Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Creditors are giving some item to the business, so they are called as giver. So it should be recorded in credit side of trial balance. Sundry creditors. How much? 26,000. Enter in credit side. Next one, sales. I told you, no, sales is a real account. So what is a real account rule? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. When you sell some item, what will happen? Goods going out. Okay, so sales goes out. So what is the rule? Real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out, no? So sales should be recorded in credit side. Why? Because it goes out. So just enter sales. How much? 2,80,000, no? Enter under credit side. Purchase always debit, sales always credit. Next up, return from customers. So you have sold some items to your customer, no? Now the customer found some defective in the item. Now they are returning the goods to you. Okay. So when you receive any item from your customer, it is a sales return. Sales is always credit. Why? Because it goes out. When you receive any defective item from customer, what will happen? Items comes in. So this will be credit. Returns will be debit. So sales always credit balance. Why? Because it goes out. Sales return, that is return from customer, means sales return. So sales returns always debit. Why? Because you are receiving item from the customer. So debit what comes in, return from customer is a debit item. So enter this item under debit side. Return from customers, that is sales return. How much? 10,000 rupees, no? Enter 10,000 under debit side of trial balance. Then next one, commission paid. Okay, in the organization you need to incur a lot of expenses, no? So you are paying some commission to the agent. So any payment will be nominal account. So all expenses and losses are belong to nominal account. In the same way, all incomes and gains also belong to nominal account. So nominal account rule is debit all expenses and losses. So commission paid, it is an expense, no? So just debit this item under trial balance. So commission paid, debit side. commission paid 750, enter on the debit side of trial balance. Next item, telephone charges. So telephone charges also is an expense. How much? 6450 debit side. How much? 6450 debit balance. Why? Because it is an expense. Next, rent and taxes. So this is also payment. So you need to pay some rents and taxes as a payment. So debit all expenses. So enter this amount under debit side of trial balance. Rent and taxes, how much? 6300 debit side. Next item, furniture. Furniture is an asset. Okay, all assets are belong to which account? Real account. What is the rule of real accounts? Debit what comes in. When you purchase furniture, what comes in? Furniture comes in. Okay, so all assets are debit balance. So enter this amount under debit side of trial balance. Furniture, how much? 11,000. Next item, purchases. So purchases also belong to real account. So real account rule is debit what comes in. When you purchase any item, here you are purchasing some goods, no? So goods comes in. So when you purchase the furniture, furniture comes in. Here they didn't mention any item, simply they have given purchase. So you can write purchase. So purchase always debit balance, sales always credit balance. So purchases, no, just enter this amount under debit side of trial balance. Purchases, how much? 1,65,000. Return to creditors. So creditor means they are supplied the item to the company. They are the suppliers. So you have purchased some item from the creditor on credit basis. Now you have found some defective in the item, the amount, the item which you have purchased earlier. So now you are returning the item to your supplier. So return to creditors or return to supplier is a purchase return. When you purchase some items, what comes in? Goods comes in. So purchase comes in. When you return some item, purchase return goes out. The items going out, no? So this should be entered in credit side. So purchase debit to purchase return credit side. So return to creditor means purchase return. This should be recorded in credit side. Return to creditors. Creditors or supplier, both are same meaning only. Just enter that amount under credit side, 10,000 rupees. Then next item is discount earned. Okay, so there are two terms are there, discount allowed and discount received. Discount earned means your supplier allowed some discount to you. Okay, it is an income. When you allow any discount to your customer, it will be discount allowed. That should be recorded in debit side. In this case, your supplier allowed some discount to you. So it is an income. You are receiving some discount from your supplier. So it is an income. So discount earned will be recorded in credit side. Why? Because it is an income. Discount earned. It's an income, no? So what is the rule of a nominal account? Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So when you receive any discount from your supplier, it will be an income. So enter that amount under credit side. Next item is salaries. So salaries also is an expense. So in the organization, you need to make payment to your employees. So when you pay salary, it's a nominal account. It's an expense, no? So what is a nominal account rule? Debit all expenses and losses, no? So salary is also one of an expense. So enter this amount under debit side of trial balance. Salaries 70,600. loan from Mohammed. Okay, so here Magnolia borrowed some amount from Mohammed for her own business. Okay, so Mohammed also provided some amount, okay, some amount into the business. So he is a receiver or giver. Loan from Mohammed. Business receives some amount, borrowings from Mohammed. So Mohammed is a giver. So Mohammed is a personal account. What is a personal account rule? Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Mohammed, giver or receiver? Giver. So loan should be recorded in credit side. It is a liability. So enter this amount under credit side. Loan from Mohammed. How much? 51,000. Then discount allowed. You have allowed some discount to your customer. So instead of 1,000 rupees, you are receiving only 900 rupees. In that case, you are allowing 100 rupees discount. No, that 100 rupees is a loss for the company. In the same way, here you are allowing discount to your customer 650. It is a loss or it is an expense. So all expenses and losses are nominal account. It should be recorded in debit side. When you earn any discount, when you receive any discount from your supplier, that should be recorded in credit balance. But here you are allowing discount to your customer. It is a loss or it is an expense. So it should be recorded in debit side of trial balance. Discount allowed 650 debit. Next one, drawings. So I told you, no, drawing is a personal account. Proprietor withdraws some amount from the business for her own purpose, for her personal purpose. So any amount withdraw from the business, that amount is called as drawings. So what is the personal account rule? Debit the receiver, credit the giver. So here owner or proprietor withdraws some amount from the business, so debit the receiver. Here drawing is the amount which is taken from the business, so enter this amount under debit side. According to the personal account, debit the receiver. Okay, he receives some amount from the business, no, so drawing should be entered under debit side of trial balance. How much? 5,000, no? Enter 5,000 debit side of trial balance. Next one, bills receivable. It's a real account. So all assets are belong to real account, no? So bills receivable also real account. When you receive any bills from the debtors or from the customer, it comes in, bills comes in. Okay, so debit what comes in? Bills comes in. So you can receive cash or bills from your customer. So instead of cash, you are receiving bills. Bills, it's a supporting document for credit transaction. When you allow credit sales to your customer, you are not receiving any cash, no? So instead of cash, you can receive bills. So bills is a supporting document for the credit transaction. At the time of credit purchase or credit sales, you can use bills. So at the time of credit sales, you will receive bills from your customer. At the time of credit purchase, you need to pay bills to your supplier or creditor. So when you receive any bills from the from your customer, it is comes in. So according to real account, debit what comes in. Here bills receivable, no, enter this amount under debit side of trial balance. Bills receivable debit side 8,600. Bad debts. Bad debts means, so generally debtors are classified into different category. Some debtors are considered as a bad debts. Bad debts means irrecoverable amount. You cannot recover amount from them. So they are called as bad debtors or bad debts. And the other two types of debtors are doubtful debts and the last one is good debtor. They are ready to pay. Doubtful debts means they may or may not pay the amount. So first one is bad debts, no, irrecoverable amount. So bad debt is a loss for the organization. 1350, it should be recorded in debit side of trial balance. How much? 1350. It's a loss. Bills payable. As I explained earlier, bills receivable is amount. When you allow credit sales, you'll receive bills from the customer. In the same way, when you go for credit purchase, you need to pay bills to your supplier. So bills payable also, it's belong to real account. So real account role is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So bills payable means it goes out. So credit this item in trial balance. Much 26,000. Next one, carriage inwards. Carriage invert, it's an expense. So carriage is an expense which is incurred at the time of acquiring raw material. Okay, so before you start production, you need to acquire some raw material. No, for that you need to incur some carriage. It's just like a transportation expense. So carriage inwards and carriage outwards. So this will be incurred before you start the production, that is at the time of purchasing a raw material. Carriage outwards means you need to incur this expense after production. Now the product is ready for consumption, you need to dispatch the item to various place. No, for that you need to incur some additional expense. So both are expense only, but this will be before production, this will be after production. So both carriage inwards and carriage outwards are expense. This should be recorded in debit side. So all nominal account rule is debit all expenses and losses. No, both carriage inwards and carriage outwards are nominal account. So debit side. Enter this item under debit side. The same way, carriage outwards also. So only one difference is there. Carriage inward is a direct expense which we use to record under trading account debit side. Carriage outward is also expense which we use to record under debit side of profit and loss account. But both are expense only. This will be before production, this will be after production. Now you can enter all these things under debit side. After entering all the item, now you need to get the total. In trial balance, you'll have equal value. Both debit and credit will always equal. If you find any difference, it shows that you have made some mistake in the problem. At the time of posting, or at the time of ledgering, or at the time of balancing, you have made some mistake. In that case, you can find some balance in the trial balance. So with the help of trial balance, you can find the accuracy of the transaction. If you get equal value, means there will be no error in the transaction. There will be no error in the accounts which you have entered in journal, ledger and trial balance. Now we can get the total. Just find the debit side total and credit side total, you will get equal value, 864,300. Here also 864,300.